Let's start. Well, we have an ankle in front of us. That is the model of an ankle. And it's a sawbone. So it will be interesting to see what's inside. I never did an arthroscopy on a sawbone. So for me, it's also interesting to know if there is a joint inside. But apparently it is. Leo has assured me that there is a joint inside. And so we will see. But the basics we can teach on a model, and probably even better than in a cadaver. Theoretically, it could be better than on a cadaver. So what you start with is the anatomy from the outside, because that determines where you have to go inside. So what you do, you palpate the fibula. Fibula is here on the outside. You can palpate. This is the tip of the fibula. And then it goes here in front. And here it goes at the back. So the fibula. What is important is to find the tip of the medial malleolus. Tip of the medial malleolus is here. Then it goes in front. Because if you know the tip of your medial malleolus, then you know the level of the ankle joint. In the sense that if this is the level of the tip, then 1.5 to 2 centimeter proximal is the level of the ankle joint. So here is the tip, so the ankle joint, the level should be here. So that's the first indication of the level of the ankle joint. Look at your x-ray, see if the anatomy is normal, so know where is the tip of the medial malleolus. Find it on palpation, and then you have your first idea of where is the level of the ankle joint. And of course, in the midline, you have your the tendons that goes to the toes, you have the neurovascular bundle, that's all here in the midline. So that's the area where you don't want to be with your incisions. Of course, here on the outside, you have the syndesmotic area. This is the outside anatomy. The next step, because the first portal that you're going to make is the medial portal. And the medial portal you will find by going a little bit proximal from the marking that you made where is the joint line. You go proximal to it, and there you palpate the distal tibia. And you will find there is a bump on the distal tibia, and then you glide down into the soft spot. So you palpate the distal tibia, you glide down into the soft spot, then you dorsiflex and your thumb gets locked into the soft spot. That's how you do it. The thumb has to come from the medial side. Don't come with your thumb from the lateral side, because then the neurovascular bundle is in the way. Don't go from proximal, don't go from distal. Come with your thumb from the medial side, palpate this bump on the distal tibia, glide down into the soft spot, lock it, go with your body, make dorsiflexion of the ankle, and now my thumb is in the soft spot. When your thumb is in the soft spot, then the joint line is in the middle of your thumb. So this is where the joint line is. Can you see it on the... Yeah. And it is exactly where is my initial drawing. So I have to check on my joint line. The next thing that you have to do is to palpate the anterior tibial tendon. Anterior tibial tendon is here. And in plantar flexion, the anterior tibial tendon moves to the medial side. Okay? In dorsiflexion, the anterior tibial tendon moves to the center of the joint. And you want it to be in the center as much as possible, because you want to have your portal as central as possible. If your portal is too medial, so if your portal would be, let's say, here, very medial, and your scope is in, then if the scope is inside, you will never be able to look at the tip of your lateral malleolus. If the scope is more central in the joint, it's positioned like this, and now we can have a look at the lateral malleolus. So try to make this portal as central as possible. And you do it by dorsiflexing. The anterior tibial tendon moves to the center of the joint, and then you go just medial from it, That's where you make your incision. I must say, on this model, it is not that easy to, because the tendon doesn't move. Okay? If you want, I can show it on one of you. If you have space to lay down, then I can show you that the tendon moves at least 1 centimeter to the center if you dorsiflex. So this is the medial portal. The lateral portal, what you want to do, you take the fourth toe, invert it, plantar flex it, and then you will see the superficial peroneal nerve. You see it? Here it is. I don't see it either, but in 60% of cases, you can see the superficial peroneal nerve. You see what I do? I draw it where I see it. I don't draw it at the level of the ankle joint, because once you made the drawing, you cannot see it anymore. And I want to be able to see it again. If I invert it, I see it here. That means that the lateral portal is either medial from it or lateral from it. Yeah? What you have to realize is you identify the nerve in this position. So the nerve is here. But when you bring the foot in the non-neutral position, the nerve moves under the skin 4 millimeter to the lateral side. So now the nerve is exactly where the portal is. Yeah? So if you mark it and you want to make your lateral portal, go at least 4 millimeter, go at least 5 millimeter away from your marking to the lateral side. But like I told you before, you want to have your portals as central as possible, so choose this portal and then you're always safe. Huh? If you take this portal, you're always safe because the nerve is not here, because the nerve is here, so it's far away from the nerve. So make your portal central, make this portal central, make it as close as you can. Yeah? If you remember that, central as possible, then you're okay. Do I look for the nerve normally? I only look at the nerve when the television is on or when there is people watching, students or visitors, then I look for the nerve. If there's nobody, I don't look for the nerve. Why? Because it's there only in 60% of cases. So in the other 40, you also have to go in blind. So why should you identify it in those 60%? The key to not have a problem with the nerve is to always go in with your mosquito clamp, go in with blunt dissection. So even if you're on the nerve, you still have no problem. That's one thing. The other thing is, you make your portals in this position, in the dorsiflex position, okay? That means if you change your instrument, so you go from this to your trocar, also bring it in the same dorsiflex position. And if you then bring in your probe, don't do it in this position, do it in the same position. Because the subcutaneous layer moves when the position moves, so you cannot go in if you make it in a different position. It's just those little tricks that make life more easy or more difficult. So, we make the skin incision through the skin only. Then you go in with your mosquito clamp. The direction that I go in is like this. It's 90 degrees. I just go in like this, to the bone, I spread it, and that should be it. In the dorsiflex, in the neutral position. Then I go in with my scope. You see, I have a 4 millimeter scope. I always use the 4 millimeter scope, the scope that you also use for the knee. It's perfect for the ankle. You go to the joint, and then very gently, you glide in front. So, hopefully I'm in the joint and you can make this motion because you have the joint capsule, so you can move in front of the joint normally. So let's see what's inside. So the first thing that you want to do when you're inside is to go to the joint line like this. The joint line should be in the middle of your view. Then you adjust the horizon. Adjust the horizon that it's horizontal. It is. Make sure that the light source is up. And you see how I hold the scope. I grab the scope between my thumb and my index finger and my longest finger, but it can also be the shortest, is here where the scope goes into the skin. So I am in control. I can go in and out. I'm in control of my scope. It's very important. If you hold it like this, it's possible, of course, but you are in less control of your scope. If you get used to this holding of the scope, you will do it for all your scopes, in the knee, in the shoulder. It gives you much more stability and control of your scope. So try it, and I'm sure that you will, if you can master it, that you can benefit from it. In the courses that I give, participants say, but my hands are too small. But I have size 7.5, so there's no excuse, because 7.5 is not very large, is it? So the trick is to put your elbow on your pelvis, okay? Because if you put your elbow on your pelvis, then it's only the lower arm that can move. If you have it like this, it's much more unstable. So put your elbow on your pelvis, give supination, full supination of your hand, and that's the way you hold it. Okay? If you hold it like this, it is much more uncertain. Anyway, we have the joint in the midline of the view, so we can do plantar flexion, dorsiflexion. And now we're going to make the lateral portal. I make the lateral portal with a needle. Do we have a needle? If not, I will use a K-wire. So, you want to have your K-wire at the level of the joint. How do you do that? Your light source is up. The joint is in the middle of your view. Now you just go in the same line as the scope. In the same line of the scope, and I put it in the same line. And then I will be exactly at the level of the joint. You see? So why am I at the... why am I not too high or too low? It is because the joint is in the middle, my view is straight posterior, then I go in the same direction as my scope, I just elongate it, I go here, and then I go inside, and I am exactly at the right level. Okay? That's the way to do it. Everybody understood what I was meaning? Any questions? I make the skin incision in the meantime. Then I go in with my mosquito clamp and I just push it in the same... You see, that's where my needle was in. So I'm almost at the place where the needle was in. I can go where the needle was in. Here was the needle in. Okay. I'm in. Now I just spread it. And that's it. And again, and that's it. And I go out. What is interesting is how you introduce, for example, your probe. Because it might very well be that you get stuck in the soft tissue when you go in, especially on the lateral side. So the way, a little trick, is to go in like this. So to go in like this. Wiggle it in. So if you are here, just wiggle it in and it finds its way into the joint. It's just a little trick. Bring it into the position of dorsiflexion in which you made the portal and wiggle it in. Or if you have this one, can you show the outside view? So if you go in, just go in like this, and it makes it much more easy to find its way into the portal, and then you're in. Okay? And now you're going to palpate the cartilage of the distal tibia, which is here loose. It's a lesion. There's an osteophyte here on the distal tibia. If we go to the medial side here, you can usually, from the medial portal, not go to the medial malleolus, but you don't want to, so you don't have to. You want to change portals in order to see the medial malleolus. In dorsiflexion, here you can take away the tissue. Well, this is an osteophyte here in front, so we have to take it away. Here you have the talus in front. And if we push in the scope to the lateral side, there will be the lateral malleolus. There's the lateral malleolus. If you plantar flex a little, then here we can go to the tip of the lateral malleolus. This is the syndesmotic ligament, the anterior syndesmotic ligament, which comes from the distal tibia here up to the fibula. This is the ATFL, the anterior talofibular ligament. It goes there from the fibula here to the talus, the ATFL. If you want to go in between, you see what I do with my thumb? I change the direction of the light source because I want to look over the edge. So I was here in the beginning, now I change it because I want to look over the edge here to go in between the fibula and the lateral facet of the talus. Okay? So you see what I do with my thumb. If I go back, I change the direction of the view again. If I go in the joint now, I can plantar flex to find an osteochondral defect here on the lateral side. Osteochondral defect which has been made. Here is the syndesmotic area. You can go in to test the stability. And then we can go and test the cartilage of the distal tibia. So in this case, we need to treat this osteochondral defect here on the lateral side. We have to take it off. The way to take it off, the best way is to use the probe. So you go like this, then you go underneath and take it off like this. Don't take it off completely, but partially like this. Then normally what I do, I go in, I turn it, maybe I can do it in this case, I don't know if it works anymore. So you go underneath it to the back, and then I lift it like this, and I pull it in front. That's the technique. And it's much more simple to do it with your probe. So it's just only attached here, so that's good. You check it, you go in like this. If you're at the end, you twist it like this, and you pull it in front. That's the way to. But of course, this is different. Normally, there's bone to it, so then it's more easy to do it. I'll show it like this. I twist it like this, and then I pull it forward. And when at the moment that you pull it forward, you close the joint, and now this is how you remove. This is how you remove the fragment. And now you close the joint so it cannot go in. So I've removed it like this. Do you have a probe or a grasper? A grasper? Can you find a grasper for me? Maybe that's a grasper, I don't know. Is it the grasper? That's not a grasper? This is something. So you go in and then you. Anyway, that's the technique. You get the idea. It's much more easy than going in with any other device. So try to use your probe to do it. Now we're going to change portals, okay? Changing portals. Outside view, yes. Changing portals. I'll show you a trick. Because the medial portal is easy, yeah? To go in with your scope like this. It's relatively straightforward. You cannot miss. The lateral portal is more difficult. The soft tissue is there. There's the nerve. It's more difficult to get in. So the way you can do it, and I currently always do it now because it's more reproducible, is as follows. You go with the probe. Yeah. So you take your trocar. You see where is the portals. This is the portal, this is the portal. So this is the distance. So I put my thumb on the trocar, and it gives the distance between the two portals. Understand what I mean? This is where is the one portal, this is where... This gives the distance between the portals on my thumb. The distance between the two portals. I keep my thumb on it, and I will go in on the medial portal, make sure I'm in the joint. I now go in front, inside the joint, like this. So now I know that the tip of my trocar is exactly in the joint at the level of the portal. Yeah, because here's the portal. This is the distance between the two portals. Understand what I mean? So if I go in like this, I know that the tip is exactly under the incision. So now I can just get it out. Why is it important to have it to do it like this? Because if the scope is in the lateral portal, you want to go straight in the joint. You don't want to go in the subcutaneous tissue and enter the joint somewhere in the middle, because then your working field is very limited. You want to be straight in the joint, because then you could also go to the lateral side. You can go in both directions. So you want to have your incision in the capsule at the same level as your skin incision, and this is the way to do it. And now you put your trocar in here, you bring it in like this, and now you've entered very elegantly the joint on the lateral side. Again, I hold it the way I've shown you before. So what you now do, you pull it back a little in order to identify the distal tibia. Distal tibia is here. Here's the joint. Sorry, here's the joint. So that's the first thing that you want to do. You want to identify the joint like I did on the lateral side. And you see, I can now go to the lateral side, go to the lateral malleolus, because the way I introduced the scope, I can go to the lateral side if I want. So you see the ATFL, you see the anterior syndesmotic ligament, there you see the fibula, which we saw from the other side also, but now you see it, you see the defect. So you see I nicely already took it out, it's already bleeding. So I just have to remove this part of the cartilage and that part of the cartilage. Can look at the syndesmotic area. Another osteochondral defect. And now if I put in the probe on the medial side. So if you put in your instrument and you want to find it, always go back with your scope like this, and then you can find your instrument. If you introduce your instrument when the scope is here, it's much more difficult to find it. Okay, always first the overview, and then you introduce it, and then you go back here. Always with any instrument change, have the overview like this, then you have a lot of space in which you can introduce an instrument, and then you go back here. Yeah, so here we look over the edge to the medial malleolus. There is some cartilage damage which we need to address. There is the osteophyte here on the distal tibia, osteophyte here. If you dorsiflex completely, then here you can see the anterior deltoid ligament. I don't know what the yellow stuff is. Huh? Ah, this is, so it says synovitis. which we have to take off. Yeah, probably. Halloween, huh? And this is the osteophyte here on the table. So you see you have to dorsiflex completely in order to really see in front, because in plantar flex you will not see it. And now we can go inside the joint to look for an osteochondral defect. And again, there's an osteochondral defect here. And the technique, again, loosen it like this. Go in with your probe like this. Like this. So you see, I use my probe as an instrument to cut also, like this. Like this. Then go in, turn it, and bring it in front. Oh, I didn't smash it, you see, it's too flexible. But you, so you see, I cut it here, but it's like this. Cut it like this. I can bring it in front. If it's in front, close it so it cannot fall back and take it out. You see, this is the best technique to for an osteochondral defect, to use your probe, because now you have nice edges. Like you see on this side, I have nice clean edges. It's the original defect that I had. And the technique, no, again, if you loosen it, just go like this, lift it, pull it back. I think that's for the moment. So do the same. And if you have created your defect, go in with your shaver. There is a shaver. I will just show you the shaver. I always use for all my scopes, I use a 5.5 bone cutter shaver. This is the bone cutter shaver. I use it for all my scopes. If you use it here on the distal tibia, here you see dionics. Can you put a clamp on it and help me? So I always ask my assistant to put something on the suction and help me with the suction. Yeah, a bigger one. I don't know if there's not a bigger one? Okay. So if you see dionics like this, it has to be like this. Because like this, you cannot damage the cartilage of the talus. Like this, obviously you go to the talus, so go like this. And then you can... and with the suction... Yeah, suction is working, I think. So you see it works greatly with the 5.5 bone cutter shaver. It goes much quicker than with other procedure, than with other shavers. You nicely can take away the osteophyte like this. That's for the osteophyte. And then for the osteochondral defect, you go in the defect like this. And then we know that there's a cyst into below it, so you go in like this. You see we nicely made the defect. So this shaver is perfect for all these defects, because you see I can very nicely go in. When you're in, you lift it, because you don't want to damage the cartilage here in front, so you lift it, and then you drive it, like this. And then you check it, and you see, we have very nicely gone to bleeding bone. And once you're there, you take your micro... So again, I go to the dorsiflex position, I go here in front, then I introduce my instrument, because else I will make damage, iatrogenic damage. I want to find it, and now I will travel together with my instrument into the defect. Like this. And I will microfracture it.
like this.
I think that,
so just to repeat it on the other side, the fluid can go in. So on the other side, the same with the shaver. Dorsiflex to, so go back to find the shaver. Yes. Okay, shaver is in. Then dorsiflexion. And we've done a nice job. Okay, go ahead.